Hello and welcome to another episode of Google Maps Developer Shortcuts. I'm Paul Saxman, and today I'm going to talk about getting data from Google Drive onto Android and into a Google Map on Android. And that's using the Google Drive web services, JSON processing in Android, and the Google Maps API, Android API V2. So to show you what I'm going to talking about here, if we go over to the tablet, I have an application here. It's just a very simple map, and I actually have a bunch of markers on here. Each of these markers, if I touch it, you can see it's a city and a population. So this is actually the natural earth data that we talked about in a previous episode on getting Drive data in a map. If you haven't seen that episode, definitely watch it. Because that actually sets the premise for actually serving JSON data from Google Drive. I actually added quite a bit more data here, so there's I think about 50 to 100 points on this map. So not too exciting. I mean, it's just a bunch of markers with info windows. You know, this is pretty simple stuff to do in Android. But what I'm going to show you now, if we go over to the Drive or go over to the Chromebook, is I'm going to go back over to my data. You can see, like I said before, I added a lot more data, about 100 points. These are actually all the cities. We have the lat longs of population. So if you saw the other episode, this should all look pretty familiar to you. I tweaked the script a little bit this time. Instead of actually, what I did last time was actually just taking the values out of the spreadsheet and JSON stringifying it. So I was actually, the JSON was an array of an array. So it was rows by columns. What I did now, though, it's a little bit different, is I'm actually using object literal notation to actually create an object. It's going to be a JavaScript object, or in this case, a Google script object. And then putting that into a collection, an array, and then stringifying that array. So the end result with that is if I call this web service, and setting up the web service was in that previous show, but if I call the service now, you can see that I have an array, and then I have key value pairs now, name Tokyo, lat long. This is actually an array itself of the lat long points, and population, which is an integer of very large size. So seeing this actually in Drive, so this is actually an index.html file that I'm actually serving from using Google Drive hosting. You can see all this data plotted on here, same idea. The very cool thing about this, though, is that this data is fully editable, right? If I want to share this information or share editing rights to the script or this the spreadsheet, you know, we can actually modify this data live, and it'll actually be represented in our web app and in our Android app. So getting this into, like I said before, this shows more about getting it in Android. To show you how that's done, we're going to go over to GitHub here. I set up a gist just to capture this data. Everything up above here, so we have a lot of information. So, you know, I have all my imports set up. You know, this is kind of standard Android stuff. If you actually use the Hello, what was it? Hello Map. Actually, Chris Broadfoot did a show a couple weeks ago that was a 5-minute getting up and running with Android development with a Google Maps Android API V2. If you run that, you'll actually pretty much start with an activity that just has the map and doesn't really render much in it. So definitely run through that application if you want to repeat what I showed here. Run through that application or that show, get that application set up, and then just paste in what I'm going to show you here. So what I did is in the setup map operation, so this is your own method that you maintain yourself. I'm actually running a new thread, and I'm calling this method retrieve and add cities. This is another method that I've set up as well. The reason I'm doing it in a separate thread is because it's a network operation. I'm actually doing a web service call, getting the data, processing it, and then plotting on the map. If we go down to the retrieve and add cities method, JSON processing in Android, truthfully, makes my eyes hurt just a little bit, but it's not too bad. All you really have to do is set up your HTTP connection. So I have a URL. From the URL, I'm getting the HTTP URL connection out, and then getting a reader. From there, I actually have to get the data out in a string so I can actually send it to the JSON library. So here, I'm actually just appending it to a string builder. And then later, what I'm doing, so I have another method. So this is actually going the inverse. Since I'm running in a worker thread, now I have to actually do the UI work back on the UI thread. The UI work is actually plotting the markers on the map, because that's a UI operation. So from here, I have a method that I called create markers from JSON. And I'm just string, you know, taking that string builder and converting it back to a string. So this is So I'm calling that method. This method is being called on the UI thread, and I'm just passing it the JSON string. And then last method, this is where the JSON processing comes into play. Like I said, I mean, this isn't nearly as clean as actually doing JSON processing in JavaScript, just because it's JavaScript object notation and not JSON or Java object notation. But you can see here, so I'm just iterating over that array that we showed earlier of JSON objects. And for each one of those, I'm just calling map.addMarker, calling the marker options, or setting up the marker options, applying the title, snippet, and position. And these three or four things are actually just coming directly out of the JSON object. So JSON object gets string from the name, to string, and I'm getting the population out, and the lat long that was an array of arrays. And then one more time, if we go back to the Nexus 10 here, the end result is pretty much this. Could show you, I mean, if I do tweak the data in the MyAwesome data spreadsheet, you'd actually see the data manipulated here, but you get the idea. So thanks for joining us this week. Again, if you want to watch the two prior episodes, it's kickstarting Android or Maps Android development using the Hello Map World or Hello Map Android application, and getting Drive data into Google Maps, and then this will get you get that data into Android. So thanks for joining us. And if you have any questions or comments, let us know. Or questions or comments, let us know in YouTube or on Google+. And with that, thanks for joining us. And all the links are in the description. So enjoy.